Welcome back to the show. As I said, a great segue, talking about some great food and, of course, that great whiskey with both Sarah and Matt from Meetings. Again, meetings.ca. You want to find out more information, and they're located down there on Kennetec Road. And why is it a great segue? Because my good friend is back on the show. Rob Statham joining me, the drunken grape himself. Welcome. How are you, buddy?
I'm great. You know, I woke up this morning and said, wow, the first segment I did was back in November of 2014 when with Groovy Grapes on Beaujolais.
It was really
10 years, almost 10 years.
That's amazing. That's amazing. And look where you are today.
I know.
Expert sommelier on everything, wine and spirits and beer. You know, this is one thing I wanted to start with because oftentimes I'm in a rush at the end of our segments, but this is what you offer. You offer tastings, right? You go, you do private parties. Tell everybody about what they can expect. What do you offer?
So I do a lot of private, corporate, governmental parties. What they can expect is I usually come on site. Usually it's into the office or the government building. They tend to like it in their facilities for things like this.
Right.
Often it goes great with like corporate meetings, for instance. It breaks up the drudgery of the day. So mm-hmm. I come in with people like Matt sometimes for meetings, or we work with their in-house chef. We put a menu together to pair these wines and beer with the food. And then we just break it down. And then right. we just present it. I get up, present it. There's a whole sensory exploration that goes with it. History, facts, all fun. And in the middle of it, I usually throw a game like trivia in the middle just to get people
nice.
Going and moving.
You know? I love it.
Get them at each other, you know, you
right.
have to.
You know, around the holidays, we like to indulge. And that's what you wanted to talk about today is, you know what? Indulge a little bit over the holidays. Go for that quality wine or beer or cider or spirit, whatever you happen to be drinking. Why do you feel that that's important around the holidays?
Well, I think quality is important.
In general,
spend
right?
a little more, get a way better product.
Gotcha.
You know, beer, for instance, you can go with your typical international styles. They're great. Stella, Heineken, you know, you get into Keats, you get into Canadian. Sure, they're consistent.
Right.
But for a little more money, you get to taste a local product. Like, I mean, Meetings is by Kennetec Road. We have a fantastic brewery here right by Kennetec Road, too. We're on it in Dominion City Brewing.
Yes.
So
fantastic
that's a great local pick. I think just supporting the local economy is critical, especially coming out of the pandemic. I mean,
Agreed.
We see the downtown core of Ottawa, for instance, it's half closed.
Yeah, having a tough
and
time,
for really
sure.
to inspire and motivate people to go out there and support the local economy because it drives everything.
Yeah, yeah. Well, listen, we just had Paul Meek from Kitchissippi. He's just
awesome.
Opening up his second location down on
great
Spark
brewery.
Street, speaking of,
Fantastic
you know, downtown,
brewery.
Right?
Yep,
but
brewery.
Let's talk about what you brought along here today. You mentioned beer. What have you got over here?
So I want to open up one with a Saison. Like,
oh, this is a beer
here? Yes. So this is a dark Saison. This is farmhouse ale. This has a lot. It's dry. It's got a lot of cranberry notes in it. It's got dark malty notes in it.
Nice.
Would go well with the gravy and the cranberry that you throw in with the turkey. You know, four things to really remember with any kind of pairing.
Yeah.
Cut, complement, contrast, and balance.
Okay.
And this is going to complement your turkey dinner.
Right.
And then help balance it out. There's some acidity in here that cuts right through the dish. Going into the pale ale, so whether you are in an American pale ale or you like strong IPAs or you want to get into the Belgian pale ale, this reminds me of Orval, which is a Trappist-style monk beer out of Belgium.
Okay.
Dominion City does Belgian-style beers so well. Like,
Brilliant.
I would really want to shout out to these guys because, you know, working with literally tasting hundreds of different beers in my lifetime or from different breweries, they're one of the best. They
Excellent.
Are fantastic. And then, of course, you have stout. Stout is awesome with dessert. You know,
oh,
you,
yeah,
have,
absolutely.
You have apple crumble, you have vanilla ice cream, you have chocolate cake, the coffee notes, and one of them is a vanilla notes. I think it's called Between Two Evils.
Yes, that's right. That's
Not
right.
The most
this
festive
one here, yeah.
name, mind you, but it's a great product, and this thing goes well with dessert.
Listen, a little bit of that even on ice cream.
Absolutely.
Would probably
just drizzle
be,
it.
Yeah, a little
yeah.
drizzle as you sip the rest of it. You brought some wine here. You actually opened
I
one up.
I have a toast for you,
okay.
my friend.
Toast
yes.
to you,
this
too.
This is Calcare. This is from Norman Hardy. This is a splash of everything from his vineyard. You've got Pinot Gris, Gewurztraminer, Chardonnay, Riesling, and Sauvignon Blanc.
All in the same
All
wine?
All the same glass.
Is that unusual to do?
Kind of.
Yeah.
That number of whites in a blend, but
that's
it's
amazing.
Delicious.
Okay, let me give it a... Oh, it smells great.
Mmm. It's almost off dry. Low alcohol, 11.6, I think, on
okay.
this. Calcare. It's calcareous soils, which are high in calcium. That's why they labeled it Calcare. One of his newest releases, he is an iconic producer. Again, going to one of the very top producers in North America with whites, particularly Chardonnay and Pinot Noir, which gives a great segue into this product. You know, yes, this is higher end. I think it's about $60 a bottle for those that want to go into the elite shop. This is much more affordable at about $25. Pinot Noir is a fickle grape, mutates in the vineyard. It's prone to disease, so to cultivate, it's tough. And he does it so well. When you've got, you know, the Baroness of the wine world, Yancis Robinson, master of wine. Mm-hmm. She's in her 70s. She's iconic. Was the Queen's cellar. She provided the cellar for the Queen at the Buckingham Palace.
Okay. Yeah, so yeah, when I guess she probably knows
this,
her stuff.
When she puts this on a high score, you pay attention.
No kidding.
And, Norman Hardy's done a fantastic job. He transitioned from a sommelier, much what I was doing, into a winemaker.
Right.
And he's become just tremendous at it. So these are just some awesome things. And, of course, we know this goes along with your turkey dinner.
Right.
If you're a pescatarian, would go well with the trout or the salmon that you could be serving as well, or something different like ham or braised beef.
I think people automatically turn to red maybe when you're talking about, you know, sort of that holiday Christmas dinner. But are there whites that fit that profile now too?
Well, I think you could have this to start things off with the salad. Okay. You know, people like to have chucked oysters and things like that at Christmas time. This is fantastic with that, calamari. There is always a sentiment because we think fireplace, right? So you think heavier beers, you think heavier wines. And another option, I don't have it here, would be Chardonnay. Get an oak Chardonnay with dinner as well. That's fantastic. Or if you want to go into a bolder red, go for a cab.
And, you know, the nice thing, too, is that you're talking about all of these are Ontario. How far have we come, Rob? Right?
Miles. When I was in university in the 90s, I remember things were in a box.
Yeah.
And the wine was crap, and it was Hillebrand. You were lucky to get a good wine. One out of five attempts might have been terrible.
It's true.
I stayed away from it.
Rob, tell everybody at home how they can get in touch with you if they want to do a private tasting.
Sure. They can reach out to me through the website. They can reach out to me at rob@thedrunkengrape.com or info@thedrunkengrape.com. I am on LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook with The Drunken Grape as a page.
Excellent.
Easy access. Social media. Gotta love it these days.
Yeah,
how easy.
Follow him, I'm telling you, on social media, LinkedIn, and his YouTube channel as well. Rob, thanks so much. Merry Christmas to you
and
your
Christmas,
family.
Merry Christmas, brother.
Thank you, pal. We'll be back with more right after this.